Dryads are a really common sight in any Sylvaneth army. They're really nice miniatures, and they're also fantastically easy to paint as well. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to paint one in the colour scheme of the Oakenbrow Glade, which is the colour scheme that you can see on the box. Now, we're going to be using the dry brushing technique quite a lot on this miniature, but also we're going to paint some smaller details like leaves and also the spikes as well. So without further ado, let's get started. With almost every model, it's best to start out with what the main area of colour is going to be, and in this case, it's going to be the brown bark for the dryad's body. So we're going to start out by base coating for all the browns that we're going to do by using dryad bark. Now, as always, remember to give all your paints a good shake before you use each colour, and because I'm going to be painting this, well, basically all over the miniature, I'm going to start out with a larger brush. I've got my large base brush for this, and what you need to do is just get some of this paint and put it onto your palette, and then add a little bit of water to it just to thin it down. Now, the reason I'm doing this is to ensure the paint dries nice and smoothly on the miniature, and also to make it go a little bit further as well. You're looking for that sort of consistency, really. Make sure you don't have too much of it on your brush, and when you're ready, all you've got to do is start painting this onto your dryad. And we're looking to get this everywhere, so really be sure to work all the way around the model, making sure you get into all the little nooks and crannies. You might need to switch to a smaller brush for some of them because the twigs can get in the way. But once I've done this coat, I'm going to apply a second thin coat in exactly the same way to ensure the final brown is nice and even across the entire miniature. With the base coat of dryad bark applied, we're now ready to move on to adding the next colour, which is actually going to be another brown, because if you look at the models in the box, they have a variety of browns on them. So we're going to add some Baneblade Brown to the model now, and this time I'm going to be applying it with the medium base brush. And basically what I'm looking to do is to pick out all the areas that I want to be, well, a lighter shade of the bark, really. So in this case, I'm looking at the limbs and also the head as well. So because I need a bit more control for this, make sure the paint's thinned down and you don't have too much on your brush. And what you're looking to do is just pick those areas out. Now, as you're doing this, just be careful around those darker bark areas, just so they stay darker. So see, I'm just being really neat around areas like this. But also you can see the colour is quite thin because it's a layer paint. So we'll be applying a second thin coat in exactly the same way to build up to a nice strong finish. Once you're happy with the amount of Baneblade Brown that you've added to your miniature, the next thing to do is to add some shade to bring these colours together and also give the model a bit of depth as well. And we're going to use Agrax Earth Shade to do this, and I'm going to be applying it with my medium shade brush. And what we're looking to do here is an all-over shade across the entire miniature. So for that reason, to get plenty of this loaded up on your palette and get lots of it on your brush, and all you've got to do is paint this everywhere. Now, as you're doing this, you're looking to make sure it settles nicely in all the recessed details of the miniature, so just be sure to poke the shade into all those details. But keep an eye on it as it dries to make sure it doesn't run and pull too much anywhere. Look particularly towards the bottom of the miniature and also on the tips of the claws as well. Now, once you've applied this all over, give it plenty of time to dry. I recommend about an hour. Once that shade is completely dry, we're ready to move on to the next step, which is to start to highlight all of that bark. And to do that, we're going to start out by dry brushing it. And the first colour for this is Sylvaneth Bark. Now this I'm going to apply with my small dry brush, and to do this, what you've got to do is just get some of this paint on the tip of your brush, then get some tissue, and use that to work the paint in amongst the bristles and get rid of the excess paint too. You want to be applying this colour in moderation and gradually building it up, so make sure there's not very much left on your brush before you apply it. And to apply it, what you need to do is, well, go for all the darker areas of bark, really. So we're looking at the middle of the body here. And all you do is just lightly start running your brush across the texture there like that, so the colour starts catching on those raised details on the corners. Now, don't worry so much about being neat on this, because this colour is quite similar to the lighter area of bark we've got. So you're just looking to focus, really, though, on the darker areas like that. With that first highlight applied, we're now going to move on to the second one, and this time we're going to use Terminata Stone, which is another dry paint, so we're going to dry brush again with it. Still sticking with a small dry brush for this, and once again what you've got to do is just get some of this on your brush, then get some tissue and use it to work that paint in amongst the bristles. Now this colour's quite light, it's quite a jump for the lighter areas of bark this, so really make sure you get rid of most of that paint so you're building this up in moderation, that way you can get a nice gradual increase on the colour up to a point that you're happy with. And what you're looking to do, as I say, is focus this on all the lighter areas of the bark, but you can also catch some of the darker areas as well, just to get a final highlight on those parts, in which case just be very light and just focus on the edges of those bits. And there we go, the dry brushing is complete, and you can leave the bark here if you want to because it looks great. But if you want to take your model up to the next level, what you can do is add an extra highlight to it. And if you want to do this, you need Pallid Witch Flesh and a small layer brush. And what we're looking to do here is to make use of the palette to thin the paint down so it's flowing nice and smoothly and is not too strong a colour. So I'm going to thin it down like this, looking for about that kind of consistency. And then you must make sure you don't have too much of this on your brush. So just drag it along and twist it to get rid of the excess paint and bring the bristles to a nice point as well. And what you're looking to do here is to pick out all the sharpest details on more prominent features. So for example, the face, I'm looking at areas where the dry brushing has just caught some edges. So things like the brow, so I just paint a bit of this colour along there. And we've also got things like the cheekbones, so I can just pick out a bit there, and also the jawline. So all areas like this, you see, where you just want to draw a bit of attention and just finish those details off. And other great areas you could do this are things like the branches on the back and also the claws as well. And with that highlight applied, the bark is now complete, and we can move on to the next detail of the miniature, which is going to be to paint the leaves. And these are scattered all over the different poses of the dryads, but all of them are painted in the same way. We're going to start out with a base coat of Caliban green, then layer over them using Elysian green. And finally, we'll add a glaze of Lamentous yellow just to give them a nice bright punch just to finish them off. But starting out with our base colour, Caliban green, I'm going to be using my small base brush to apply this. And what you need to do is just use your palette to get the paint under control, because these details, they're quite small, so you want to be really neat with this. So thin your paint down so it's flowing smoothly. Get rid of the excess paint off your brush by just twisting it like that. And then it's just a case of picking out these leaves. In this case, they all tend to be up here just behind the head. And all you've got to do is be as neat as you can as you apply this colour. And as you can see, it's a little bit transparent, so I will be applying a second thin coat in exactly the same way once the first one is dry. Next, add a layer of Elysian green to each of the leaves using your small layer brush. And what you want to do here is paint most of the leaf, but basically either side of it, so that you leave a small amount of Caliban green showing down the centre of each one. And finally, to complete the leaves, apply a glaze of Lamentous yellow onto each one using your small layer brush. And you don't need very much of this. In fact, keep control of it, because you don't want to get this yellow onto any of the bark. And with that, the leaves are complete. Now, the next detail that we're going to paint is the dryad's eyes. And for this, the only colour you need is Evil Sun Scarlet. But because they're so small, you need the finest brush that you've got. So in my case, I'm going to be using my extra small Artificer Layer brush. And what you need to do is to make sure you use your palette to be sure the paint's thin so it's flowing easily. Because you need to have a very small amount in your brush, but it needs to apply, well, straight away, really. So make sure you thin your paint down to about that kind of consistency. Get rid of the excess so you've got that really fine tip in your brush. And then it's just a case of bracing your hands as steadily as possible and just touching the tip of the brush, just that raised surface of the eye in the centre of the socket, there like that. And there we go. And with the eyes painted, the dryad is, well, pretty much complete, except this particular one is a bit unusual because it's got a spite on the back of it, so we need to paint that now. We're going to paint it blue. So to do this, I'm going to start out with a base coat of Calidore Sky and then layer it using Lothurn Blue. After that, I'm going to shade it with Drakenhof Nightshade before finishing it off with a highlight of Baharoth Blue. But starting out with our base colour, Calidore Sky, I'm going to be using my small base brush to apply this, and well, like usual, just need to make use of your palette to thin the paint down so you can ensure that it dries nice and smoothly, and also to make sure you don't have too much paint in your brush. But once you're ready, all you've got to do is base coat it, and as you do so, just be careful because it is sort of twisted around some branches on here. So just take your time to make sure you're painting all the bits of its skin and be really neat around that bark. The next stage is to apply a layer of Lothurn Blue using a small layer brush. And for this colour, what you want to do is to paint most of the spite, just leave the darker bill still showing in the deeper recesses. With that layer done, the next thing to do is to use Drakenhof Nightshade to shade the spite, and I'm applying this with my medium layer brush. You're looking for a thin coat of this and not to put on too much at once, because you don't want to lose control of it and get it onto the bark. Once the shade's completely dry, all that remains to complete the spite is to highlight it using Baharoth Blue with your small layer brush. And all you need to do is just pick out some of the raised details with some fine lines just as neatly as you can. And once you've done this, well, the entire dryad is complete. And all you have to do is just base it. And as always, I recommend you base it in the same way as the rest of your army. There we go, with the base done, the dryad is complete. And as you've seen, these are very simple models to paint, which means it's easy to get a fantastic result. So the things to remember about painting dryads is that when you're dry brushing their bark, remember to build up that colour gradually so you get a nice transition between the darker areas and the lighter areas. And later on, when you're painting the finer details on them, just be as neat as you can to really pick out all those features and get a nice sharp result with them. And well, there you go, that's really all there is to it. So have fun painting your dryads, and we'll see you again very soon with another tutorial. If you enjoyed that tutorial and you'd like to see more, then why not subscribe to our YouTube channel, Warhammer TV, which is full of loads of other tutorials, but also trailers and miniature showcases too.
If you want to watch some right now, why not check out some of the videos down below?